Hey, what's up everyone? This is Mark and today I'm gonna give you 7 tips to help you learn Thai. Now, tip number 6 is gonna be the most useful in my opinion. It's one that people don't talk about. Of these 7 tips, some of them are gonna be applicable to other languages, but a few of them will be really applicable to the Thai language. Now, instead of me just sitting in front of a camera and talking about them, we are here at Lumpini Stadium because I am the bilingual ring announcer for the fights here. So I'm gonna take you through my process, give you some tips on how to do it, show you some of the fights and have some fun. Okay, so I'm backstage here. I'll take you to go and see the fighters in the locker room in just a second. So the show is at 10 a.m. on a Saturday morning on Channel 7 HD. I get my script through on the Friday. So basically I go over the script just to see if there are any changes, what I need to talk about, things I might need to promote. But when I'm on stage, I don't really read it. I don't follow the script. I just sort of go. So that brings me to tip number 1. Really focus on learning whole, complete sentences rather than just like, I'm gonna learn a word a day. That doesn't tend to work out very well. When people learn words, they end up knowing a lot of words, but they can't fluently roll them off and speak with other people. Now, Thai is an interesting language. The verbs and nouns don't change form. So in English, go, went, gone, goes. In Thai, it's just pai. When it comes to nouns, again, they don't have plural nouns. It's just the same word. So that means that when you learn sentences you get a new word, you can just swap it out and you can start speaking much more fluently. So tip number 1, focus on learning sentences more than trying to learn new words. All right, let's move on to tip number 2. Tip number 2 is practice speaking a lot. Now, this one's obvious and everyone's gonna tell you that, but I don't think people do it enough. Like, you need to strike up conversations with people, whether that's your taxi driver, whether that's the 7-Eleven staff. Just ask them something, like, are they open tomorrow? Just start practicing things you've learned, new things you wanna practice and go out and say. You have to practice because in the initial stages, if you don't use it, you will lose it. Now, after a while, when fluency sort of kicks in, you'll know it, but you really need to use it a lot. And then when you use it, listen to the way they respond to you, because you might use it incorrectly, and then when you listen to the response back, you'll hear the correct way of using it. So really practice it a lot, as much as you can. So that's tip number 2, practice as much as you can, and again, that goes for any language. Still one of our raps men, raps and cuts. Here we have Fani Palumpi, the BKFC Thailand champion. She's fighting in Muay Thai today. And because she's crazy, she's fighting in MMA on Wednesday. That's insane.
We have 7 fights. It's going to be extreme 3 fights. The most important fight today is almost every fight. But the fight that I'm looking for is the fight of Yodesha Fatak เวชสุวรรณพอเจริญแพทย์และที่ต้องน่าดูที่สุดคือบาบาร่ากับฟานี่ซึ่งเป็นสุดยอดของมวยหญิงในน้ำหนักนี
้ So that was our matchmaker and that brings me on to tip number 3. Learn Thai from someone whose character is somewhat similar to yours. Now, I'm not saying don't learn from a woman if you're a man or don't learn from a man if you're a woman. That's great for learning sentence structures. It's great for learning words and, you know, pick whoever you enjoy learning with the most. But when I'm talking about when you're copying the way in which the language is actually used, you've got to be a little bit, I don't want to say careful, but just, you know, think about it a little bit. There was a guy in my office from England and he said "Jabala" to someone, which means like, are you crazy? But men don't say that. Men would say "Ey ba," which means, are you crazy? I think the best example would be in English, the word fabulous. Like, I wouldn't really use the word fabulous, right? So you kind of want to listen to someone whose voice you can copy, the sounds you can copy, and the mannerisms you can copy. And that way there, you're going to sound the way you want to sound. And I think people overlook that. So tip number 4 is learn the tones. Really try to nail the tones. Now, you should do this one when you're learning the words, but don't obsess over to the point where you don't want to actually go out and speak because you're scared of getting it wrong. One of the things that I think really needs to be said here is the tones are relative, they're not absolute. I'm terrible with music, but I still manage to get the tones in Thai. Some people say they're tone deaf. When it comes to a tonal language, there's no such thing as being tone deaf. Because if there were, then you'd have a lot of Thai native speakers who never quite mastered their own language, and that doesn't happen. Or you'd get Chinese speakers who never quite learned to speak Chinese like a person from China. So it doesn't happen. So really try and focus on them, but don't obsess over them. What about vowel length, I hear you say? A lot of people say, well, vowel length is more important than the tones. First of all, it's not more important than the tones. I'm gonna just go straight out and say that's a lie. They're not more important than the tones. But what I will say is that yes, you should focus on them, but they're quite easy, right? Because you've got short and long, so just kind of try to remember which one it is and don't change that. That being said, there is a bit of flexibility in the language, and you're gonna see in my ring announcing where I kind of toy around with it in order to make it a bit more powerful when I announce. And that flexibility, almost like a poetic license, is absolutely fine. And there are some words where they make it long just to be more playful. So yes, focus on them, but it's not nearly as important as the tones. So the show is gonna be going live in about 45 minutes, and I'm gonna go and run over my script. Obviously that's the stage there. The fighters come down from over there, walk in, they fight. The crowd, cameras, action. This guy filming some action on his phone. And then we got the TV stuff here. Lots of great fights today.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to FedEx Fight Muay Man Pan Extreme. สวัสดีครับขอต้อนรับทุกท่านเข้าสู่รายการ FedEx Fight มวยมันพันเอ็กซ์ตรีมพบกันทุกวันเสาร์ตั้งแต่10โมงเช้าถึงเที่ยงวันทางช่อง7 HD ครับท่านผู้ชมครับเสาร์หน้าเป็นรอบชิงชนะเลิศของมวยรอบของเรานะครับ FedEx Fight Road to One Thailand นะครับซึ่งจะทบทวนนะครับว่ามีใครบ้างในรุ่นอัจฉมวยหรือว่า 52.2 กิโลครับท่านผู้ชมครับคู่แรกในวันนี้จะชกกันในรูปแบบมวยไทยพิกัด65กิโล3ยกยกละ3นาที The first bout of the day is a Muay Thai bout at 65 kilograms scheduled for 3 minute rounds นักมวยในมุมดำ The fighter in the black corner น้ำหนัก65กิโลสูง182 weighing in at 65 kilograms standing 182 centimeters tall มาจากสหรัฐอเมริกา From the United States of America this isKendu Irving!
That's a magical haircut. What happened there?
I just had my third fight at Lupini. I wanted a new style, you know, so got cut and now I'm having your look.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is it for us here on Channel 7 HD. From me, Mark Abbott, the team here, Fairtex, Lumbini. I'll see you next week. สวัสดีครับ
All right, so we'll give vowel lengths as the tip number 5. Tip number 6, the one that I feel is the most important, and that is to put your ego aside. Now, the ego manifests itself in a lot of different ways, but I think what happens with this is people get laughed at, and then they go, no, screw it, I don't want to do it. It may be subconscious, but they're like, no, I don't want to do it. As we get older, we typically don't do new things, or we stick to the things that we're good at. I mean, thinking about your job, you get promoted into more and more specialized work that you're really good at, and you kind of forget what it feels like to suck at something. You know, children, a lot of things they're doing, it's the first time they've done it, they suck, they get laughed at. As we get older, we get laughed at because we say something wrong, and then we take it to heart, and we don't want to speak it anymore. We need to put our egos aside, we need to laugh. If you make a mistake, yeah, they're gonna laugh at you. You know, they'll laugh at you. Laugh with them. Find out what the word was that you actually said. Find out what you were trying to say, and now you know two words and you've got a good story out of it. So So I'd say the most important thing out of all of these is to relax, laugh at yourself, and put your ego aside.
Okay, so I closed out the show and now I'm in my car ready to go home with the final tip, tip number 7. Now, some people might be confused as to why I didn't put this as tip number 1 or the most important tip, and that is to learn how to read and write. The reason why I haven't got it as the most important or tip number 1 is because it depends on the learner. If you want to be able to speak Thai in a way where you can converse with people here and there, you enjoy the culture a bit more, you can sort of describe a bit more about the way you want the chef to cook your food, you don't need to learn how to read and write. Let's be honest. But if you want to achieve true fluency, I don't think there's any more important tip that I could give you than to learn how to read and write. Now, I've tried to work out how to say this without sounding like an asshole, but I've given up because it's just going to sound like an asshole. Many a time have I met, you know, a guy say, oh, my friend speaks Thai fluently, but he can't read and write. And then I meet them and it's atrocious. I mean, they're spewing out a lot of words, but it's a headache to listen to. Now, I'm not having a go. I mean, that's fine. We all are on different, you know, stages in our journey of learning Thai. But to the untrained ear, that might sound fluent. But from someone who is actually fluent, it sounds terrible. When I meet a foreigner who speaks legitimate fluent Thai, I'm like, damn, that's good. 100% of the time, they can read and write. 100%. Now, I'm not saying there are no foreigners out there who can't speak fluent Thai with you know, without having learned how to read and write. I'm not saying they don't exist. But having been here for as long as I have and met, you know, as many people as I have, when you speak to foreigners who sound fluent but it's not good versus those who sound awesome, the differential factor is always the ability to learn how to read and write. So if you want to take it to the next level, expose yourself to signposts, magazines, books, articles, messages, learn new words and really immerse yourself in the language, learn how to read and write. Anyway, that's all I've got time for today. I do apologize if the video didn't flow as well as I would have liked it to, but as you can imagine, I hope you can understand, it's really difficult to host a TV show bilingually that's live as well, so things are always changing, and then film vlogs and stuff at the same time. So I do apologize if it wasn't as smooth as I'd liked it to have been, but I hope you came away with those tips and found them useful, and I'll see you next time. Have a good day, everyone.